and welcome. In this week's video, I'm going to be explaining a manifold absolute pressure sensor. Now, a MAP sensor can be used in place of a mass airflow sensor in order to detect how much air is going into the engine so that the engine knows how much fuel to put in. So let's take a look at this on my car first before I explain how it works. So here we have the air intake for my engine, and if we follow that, we get to the throttle body. Now, connected to the throttle body, we've got the intake manifold, and mounted directly on top of the throttle body, we have the manifold absolute pressure sensor, which is what I'm going over in this video. So let's take a look at what's going on inside of that little sensor I just showed you. So what we have is, there is a tube that'll lead to the intake manifold, or the throttle body, and it'll have that negative pressure, basically, compared to atmospheric, of the vacuum. And so that vacuum will be coming in on this side, and then we'll have a sealed chamber inside of that pressure sensor, and this will either be a vacuum or a controlled pressure that's calibrated for the engine. So let's just call it a vacuum for this purpose. And then we've got a silicon chip, which will be the divider between the vacuum and the vacuum from the intake manifold. Now this silicon chip is flexible, and it's got a current running through it, and that reading is being sent off to the ECM, or the ECU. The ECM, a part of the ECU. So what's happening is, when you press on the gas pedal, you're going to increase the pressure inside of the intake manifold. There's going to be less of a vacuum. And so when there's less of a vacuum, it's going to push up on that silicon chip and force it to flex upward. And when it flexes it upward, it's going to alter its resistance. So if you take your foot off the gas, you're going to have more of a vacuum in the intake manifold, so that silicon chip's going to come back down like that. So as I was saying, it alters the resistance of that silicon chip. So the process that the ECU reads and manipulates is, you press on the gas pedal, that's going to allow more air to go in. With more air, it's going to flex this silicon chip. Now when it flexes the silicon chip, it's going to cause a resistance change. The ECU takes that resistance change and translates it into a voltage change. With that voltage change, it knows that it needs to either inject more fuel or inject less fuel. Now, it's going to use the MAP sensor in addition to an engine speed sensor and an air temperature sensor. These are important because you have to know how many power cycles you've got in order to know how much fuel you're burning. And you also need to know the temperature of the air, because cooler air is more dense, holds more oxygen. So I've built a little chart here that explains what the ECU is going to do in order to tell the fuel injectors to inject more or less fuel, depending on a variable. So, if you increase the variable, what do you need to do? If you decrease this variable, what do you need to do as far as fuel injection? So, if absolute pressure increases, the silicon chip flexes upward, the engine knows that it needs to inject more fuel because more air is coming in. If you decrease it, then you use less fuel. If the temperature is going down, if it's a low temperature, So the scenario I'm talking about is, if the temperature is going down, if you have a cold temperature, then you're going to need to inject more fuel because there's more oxygen in cooler air. So vice versa, if you have a higher temperature, air temperature, then you inject less fuel because there's less oxygen. And quite obviously, if the engine speed is higher, you're going to inject more fuel, and if the engine speed is lower, you're going to inject less fuel. So I hope you've enjoyed this. Leave any questions or comments below.